healing power of food is unquestionable, and it's been known for centuries and is accepted around the world, from the Chinese who say qi yao. Is that how you say it?
I'm not Chinese, okay. But it sounds
good
to me.
Which means eat medicine, to ancient Greek physician Hippocrates, who said, let food be thy medicine. And here today with the latest research on eating for your health is senior editor at Body and Soul magazine, Terri Trespicio.
Thank you. Nice to have you.
Thanks. And why don't many Americans emphasize the importance of food as medicine? Why? What's wrong with us?
What's wrong with us? I don't think it's that we don't embrace food. We certainly love food, but we're very quick to rely on drugs to solve our problems. Also, we're stressed, and when we're stressed, we go to convenience foods. And when we start relying more on those junk processed foods as our main source of nutrients, we're crowding out the good stuff. So I think those, and also, it's very confusing out there, all the mixed
packages,
messaging.
Cans. Stopping on your way home for fast food, you're doing the wrong thing.
Here's what I think. If you get in your car and anything you bought is ready to eat right there, you're not buying enough whole foods. Lately, when I get in the car, I say, what can I eat on in the meantime? Unless I want to chomp on kale, there's not much there. So that's how you know you're good. You're doing some good shopping.
Or dirty carrots.
Right. Here's the thing. We're going to talk about some of the foods that are not so great. But this doesn't mean we mean to vilify these foods. We've all eaten this stuff at one point or another, and the occasional indulgence is not so bad.
There were three.
I know. I heard. I saw. Then one disappeared. Mysteriously.
My favorite junk food in the entire world. I didn't eat all of it. I just ate the little.
A little piece.
That's right. I gave the rest away.
Well, the idea here is we want to. What's going to prevent disease in the long term? Remember that food is the cheapest, safest way to maintain your health long term and to ward off disease. The occasional sticky bun is not going to do this damage. We're talking big patterns. So let's talk about why some of these things are not so great and why we want to minimize.
This actually doesn't look so good.
It doesn't?
It looks like it will hurt you.
Well, it's not the picture of health, I would say. But beef can be certainly part of a good diet, especially if you have grass-fed beef.
Yes.
But too much beef and too much meat.
Absolutely grass-fed beef.
Right.
Okay.
Or if you're, you shouldn't be eating this every day, right?
No.
But this is, so we'll move that away. The problem with that is that it's saturated fat, saturated fat. I don't know. I thought maybe you took a little, sip.
No, I didn't take any of that.
I don't know what's in it.
That obviously, any alcohol.
Well, here's the thing. We know that research says some alcohol is good for your heart.
Like red wine.
Right, but if you're worried about cancer, the risks of alcohol far outweigh the benefits, particularly for women and breast cancer. So it's really important that if you don't drink, don't start.
Alcohol.
And if you drink, very little, little. So, and then we have cheese, by the way. Again, another processed.
Now, I went to a spa, and guess what the snack food was?
They did not serve
this
that.
This stuff, they did. They did. I had never seen it before. believe me. Somebody had talked about string cheese, right? Isn't that string cheese?
Yeah, I think so.
It's not your best. I can't even believe people would eat that.
I know.
That.
It's
like eating a piece of rubber.
Doesn't taste really great. It's also high in saturated fat. And a lot of the processed meats and cheeses out there use nitrates, nitrites, and their preservatives. And they can be toxic,
This is hideous.
This is, again...
Their problem...
not great. Again, snack food. You don't want to be... The problem is you start eating like that. They're probably corn twisty, crunchy, cheesy things. I don't know. I don't really eat them.
And they make your tongue orange.
They make everything orange.
Yes, okay,
we'll get rid of that. Now,
but
that's
a lot of chemicals and a lot of corn.
A lot of corn, a lot of chemicals. And what happens is you just keep eating it. This stuff, we can group this all together as refined sugar and flour. Too much foods that are too high in refined sugar and carbs. Well, the problem is it promotes inflammation at the cellular level. And inflammation is the precursor to disease. So it's not that you can't eat this stuff sometimes, but really let's steer clear of the refined sugar. So let's move on.
Sticky buns, donuts.
We instinctively, this is not going to make you healthier. We know this. So let's talk about some foods that are actually backed by research to help prevent and treat.
This table does not look as appetizing.
Well, again, you can't eat it in the car. You're not going to be throwing this back,
I'm just joking because this is the way you have to eat.
This is the way you want to eat most of the time.
Yes.
So let's talk about, first we have heart disease here, some things that are great for your heart. Whole grains, like rice, we have black, red, and brown rice here. Also, oats have been shown to be great for your health, for your heart. Whole grains kind of mop up the artery clogging cholesterol, so that's great. Beans,
red beans, black beans,
the darker the color,
the
more antioxidants. What those do is give you more magnesium, and they help regulate your blood pressure.
Now, when you get home and you're by yourself,
and
you're really tired, and you don't want to cook, what would you eat?
My go-to is garlic, olive oil, which is a really heart-healthy choice. Polyphenols in there shown to keep your bad cholesterol at bay. I take cholesterol, throw it in a pan. No, I take some garlic and olive oil, and I keep greens. and I throw in some greens and saute it, and add a little soy sauce with a rice or some grain and some beans, and I eat that. I eat like really like simple peasant food.
I go for that.
I love that too.
I go for a can of sardines. I have I have stacks of sardines.
I have sardines. You know, I like too is trout, herring, small fish. Great, 2 to 7 servings a week.
Yeah.
And the reason why the small fish is because they have lower levels of toxins. So salmon, of course, so great for you. High in omega-3s. Great for curbing inflammation. These things pump up your inflammation. These things curb it.
Okay.
So that's good for heart disease. Let's move on to cancer. Foods that prevent cancer. Any diet, any good diet, is not going to be complete without greens.
Kale.
Yummy.
Swiss chard.
It's good when you cook it up.
But look how beautiful that Swiss chard is.
It's pretty.
Oh,
but
is.
This is what you really want to focus on. Broccoli has been shown. You chomp on these florets. It releases cancer-fighting compounds. You want to eat this 4 times a week, cooked and raw combination, and they can actually inhibit the growth of tumors. So a good reason to have that. Tomatoes.
And those are brassicas. Anything
brassica
in the brassica family.
Right.
That's cauliflower. That's Brussels, no, not that's
not Brussels
no,
sprouts.
No, not Brussels sprouts, no.
I'm blanking
broccoli.
On it. But broccoli in particular is where the research is, so that's why I say that. Tomatoes have lycopene, that's what gives them the red color. They shield cells, they protect them from cancer-causing oxygen damage.
Okay, but they have to be organic tomatoes.
Organic tomatoes is the goal, and you want some fresh and some cooked, because when you cook tomatoes, it actually concentrates the lycopene, which is what you want. Berries, we know, high anthocyanins, which are antioxidants that battle free radical damage. Mushrooms is where the new research is coming from. Throw some of these shiitake mushrooms in your soups, your stir fries, find reasons to cook with them. I like this, actually. I take this myself. New Chapter Organics Host Defense combines some of the most powerful
premier mushrooms.
Combines a lot of the powerful mushrooms, and you just take 2 a day and revs up your immunity and kills the bad guys. That's how you think
of
mushrooms.
Are you ever sick? Do you ever get sick?
I was sick a few years ago, and my immunity was bad, so I went on this, and then I've been great since. Let's wrap up with type 2 diabetes. We have carotenoid-rich fruits and veggies, mango, sweet potato, spinach. There are a bunch of others, cantaloupe, things like that. These regulate your blood sugar. They calm inflammation. That's what these are famous for.
I love
lentils.
What about papayas?
I don't know about papayas. Very high in sugar, too, but mangoes in particular.
Yeah. Okay.
Lentils are what's going to, they're going to regulate your blood sugar. And the newest research is around spices, cinnamon and turmeric.
Yes.
These have been shown to have great for treating and even preventing diabetes. So cinnamon, put it on your toast, put it on your cereal or whatever in the morning. And turmeric, throw that into your soups and stir fries. Mm-hmm. Use it every time you cook. And ever since I learned that, I started just throwing it in.
And it's good for you.
Right.
Turmeric tea is awfully good, too.
Is it? You can take some turmeric, add it to water, some honey, and sip that if you don't think you're getting enough. Yeah. But
is it possible to have too many of these foods or too much of one kind of food?
Probably not. Most people are not getting their 9 to 11 servings of fruits and veggies a day, which is what is recommended. Do you know anyone who ODs on kale? I don't. Chances are that when you're eating whole foods, you know when you're full and you know when you've had enough.
I have a housekeeper who got breast cancer. And she's been working for me for like 27 years. She got breast cancer. She eats the healthiest diet. She eats everything on this table every day.
Right.
Kale every single day.
Well, that could be a little deadly. I'd shake it up a little.
No, she loves kale.
She likes it.
No, but she has her grains. She has her, every day she just shows me what she's eating. It's the most delicious
And you can vary
food.
It. Yeah, it's delicious.
It's
and
delicious.
You feel full and you feel great.
Yeah.
So I can't recommend it highly enough.
Yep. And for a list of even more foods and the diseases they help prevent, visit our website, wholeliving.com, or pick up the current issue of Body and Soul magazine, which we got a little bit wet here. And everyone in our studio audience is taking home a copy. Be sure to listen to Terri on the radio weekday mornings at 10 on Sirius Channel 112 and XM 157. Terri, as usual, informative and thorough.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.